This house actually looks better than it used to, and much of that is these two right here. That is Eric Lavelle and his daughter, Claire. You guys have done so much work on this over the years.
We've been here part-time for about 4 years, and we work with the Ludkeys side by side. It's an enormous project.
You see a lot of ghosts when you're working?
Had a couple of weird things happen.
What happened?
Well, with the doors were off, the original doors were off the hinges for decades. And when we put them back on, the wind was blowing them shut. We went to lunch and we came back, they were still shut. And then I reached down to pick up my tools and they were wide open. They wanted me to come in and put the doorknob on.
That is scary stuff right there. Claire, what about you?
I had this one time where I was in the house and I was starting to go down into the cellar and I heard this loud crashing noise. I couldn't find anything that fell when I went downstairs though.
Welcome to the McPike Mansion. The entire house isn't open. It's still under renovation. Nobody's lived in here since the 1950s. But the sub-basement, the root cellar, the wine cellar, it's open. Ooh! Oh my gosh, who are you people?
Oh, well, we're George and Sharon Ludke, and we own this place.
I've heard of you before.
Well, great.
This is kind of a scary place. Tell us about some of your stories.
About 7 weeks after we bought the house, I saw a man in the second story window. And that was kind of unnerving, actually. He had a striped shirt and a tie on. I do believe that was Paul Oeschinger that I saw.
Who's that?
He and Shuggy actually were the last people to live in the house. So Paul died. We're not sure if he died in the house or at the hospital, since that was the early 1950s.
Who are the ghosts? Who do they say?
Well, we have a lot of spirits, about 10 spirits. And I do want to say George has seen some Indian spirits too.
Is that right, George?
Yeah, there's probably two experiences I had early on.
I've had a few unnerving experiences, actually. And one of them was in the cellar here. And we had a group of probably fifth and sixth grade boys and some of their parents. And I had asked the spirits to join us in sight or sound or touch or smell, as long as it does, you know. And all of a sudden, the cellar doors slammed shut. And it was very unnerving. And I was pretty scared, but I kept my cool. And I said, spirits, I would appreciate it if you would not be so loud. So we stayed for a few more minutes and then we left. But that was pretty unnerving for me, actually. Actually, it was.
So if your life's a little dull and you need a little excitement, the McPike Mansion in Alton, Illinois is always waiting. You'll never be the same after a tour of this place.